Namaste children, myself Vishwanath from Pearl Public School. Today I am going to start the second lesson in history part in your social book. The second lesson is that from hunting, gathering to growing food. I think you already know about the hunting and gathering. Our ancient people who were uncivilized, they were hunting the animals for their food. They are getting their food by hunting the animals, and that activity is called hunting and gathering. Not only our ancient people, they not only hunted the people, but also they gathered, they collected different types of roots, different types of food, different type of fruits for their food. So this activity, collecting of fruits, roots and many other things for their food, is called as gathering. The ancient man, he was leading his life, he was finding his food by hunting and gathering. Later, he learned, gradually, he learned how to get his food on his own. He learned how to grow it. That is what called civilization. From uncivilized status to civilized status, he started to get developed by himself. He was hunting, gathering, but now he slowly started to grow his food. So this process, how he learned from hunting, gathering to growing food, you are going to learn in this lesson. So this hunting and gathering, in this activity, the people who were living in group, they were uncivilized. They don't know how to grow the food. They were in movement. They were not staying in one place, as there are so many reasons behind this. Why our ancient people did not live in one place? Till Indus Valley civilization, we are not having any location where the man lived in one place. He was roaming. So there are so many reasons behind them. Behind the movement of the people in ancient periods. What are those reasons? There are four major reasons we can find here. That is availability of food, movement of animals, different seasons and water resource. Let us get to know in detail about these reasons. Availability of food. Our ancient man, he learned that if he stayed in single place for long period, there were chances for the food to get exhausted. It is going to be end. If he stayed in one place and consumed food, so that he, when the food was not available, he moved to another place where the food is available. So that is how this availability of food become a reason for the movement of the people in ancient periods. Then the second one, movement of animals. As we all know that he was hunting animals, right? Those animals were moving in search of water and food. Those animals also moving in search of food and water from place to place. And some animals, even they moved from one place to another place in threat of wild animals. For example, deer, you can take, it is having the fear of lion, tiger, these type of animals. Because of that, what happens? Those type of
one place to another place. So these reasons are there for the movement of the animals. So animals have become the food of ancient people. So they are moving along with these animals for their food. As animals moved, even the ancient man. So this is also one of the major reason for the movement of the people in ancient periods. Then different seasons. As I told that to find his food, he was only going to activities, that is hunting and gathering. Here, when it comes for gathering, he had to collect different types of fruits, right? Fruits will be having seasons. In different seasons, different fruits will be available. So when he stayed in one place, for example, it is mango season. Mango is available now. But other fruits like jackfruit and other types of fruits are not available now. So when that season comes, we are getting that. In the same way, the ancient people, here we are having fruit seller. They are bringing from one from where they grow. Those fruits are grown from that place to here. They are putting it and they are selling. Because of that we are getting. But in the olden days there was no transportation. Where they are available, there only we have to move. Not we, our ancient people. So in different seasons, in different places, they are getting food. Because of that they move from one place to another place. Then the last and very important reason behind the movement of the people in ancient period, that is the water resource. Water is one of the main thing for everyone, for all living beings to live. So whenever the water resource get emptied, the man moved in search of water, in search of water resources where it is available. Because of that, the ancient people, they came and settled in the Indus, on the banks of Indus River. You can see most of the civilizations, not most, all the civilizations, I can say all the civilizations have started on the banks of the river itself because of water resource. So in search of this water resource, the people or ancient people moved from one place to another place. Later, they started to live in one place. Then, when water is available, they have observed how the plants are growing. So, they came to know the activity, the farming activity. Then they started growing food. You will come to know about this in this lesson itself in the next parts. Then when these people moved from one place to another place, it was noticed. You can question me that how we are getting these type of informations about the movements of people, about the settlements of the people. So here we can see archaeologists, one who finds all these things. These archaeologists says they are going to dig the ground. That process can be called as excavating. So by this they are going to find out in some places, in caves or in some on the banks of the river, they have found tools of stones, like old people like eggs. These type of tools they have made by stones. Those tools were found in some places. Wherever they found those tools, they have noticed, they have studied that, they came to a decision that the people lived in that place. And wood and bones which they used to prepare some other tools. It may be for their farming activity or it may be for hunting. So they have made some of the tools from stones, wood and bones. These stones, the remains of these tools were available. They were found in some places. By that we came to know about those people, how they lived. Then scrap bark which they used, the outer layer of the stem of a tree. Then animal skins which they used to protect themselves from the cold. So these reasons, by these things we came to know through archaeologists about their settlements. In the next class we are going to know, we are going to discuss about how the ancient people were choosing a place to live in. What are the demands, what are the factors that made them to settle, made them to choose a place to live. Thank you.